Hey, it's Melanie. I just wanted to jump on and say thank you so much for listening to the Eat Away Kidney Stones podcast. I've been truly blown away by all the kind and wonderful comments people have been leaving for me about the podcast. If you are enjoying the podcast, please consider leaving a review on whatever platform you listen to your podcast on. This really helps me help more people prevent kidney stones. I hope you enjoy today's episode. Welcome to the Eat Away Kidney Stones podcast. I'm your host, registered dietitian, and kidney stone expert, Melanie Betts. After learning a ton about kidney stones and helping people prevent stones at the University of Chicago, I was fed up with all the terrible advice people were finding online. So I decided to do something about it. The Kidney Dietitian was born. This podcast is for people who want to learn what actually works to prevent kidney stones and still enjoy life, eating, and their favorite foods. Let's dive in. Oh, and welcome to the 46th episode of the Eat Away Kidney Stones podcast. As always, I'm your host, registered dietitian and kidney stone expert, Melanie Betts. And today's episode is going to be a little bit different, but I thought it might be kind of fun. I just this past weekend got back from the National Kidney Foundation Spring Clinical Meeting. And I had such a wonderful time and had so many amazing conversations with so many other amazing kidney dietitians. I just wanted to kind of share my thoughts after the meeting and kind of share my thoughts about the state of kidney stone nutrition in the country and also where maybe it's going. So just for those of you that don't know, the National Kidney Foundation is, of course, a national organization that promotes kidney health. They do a lot of advocacy and a lot of really wonderful public education, both for patients and for healthcare professionals. There are kind of two big national organizations in the United States for kidney professionals. So this includes nephrologists as well as dietitians and social workers and pharmacists and nurses and kind of everyone who you might come across in your kidney journey. And so those two organizations are the National Kidney Foundation, which is where I was last week. Their meeting was in Long Beach, California. I was there from May 13th through 19th. I think those dates are correct. It was wonderful. So I'll talk more about that in a second. So that is one organization, and they do a lot of, again, public outreach, and also have a lot of content for not just doctors, not just nephrologists, but for dietitians. I actually learned that dietitians, in terms of members of the National Kidney Foundation, make up the largest percentage of NKF members, which I think is amazing. That shows that there is a huge interest in dietitians, at least renal dietitians, to learn more and be involved at these national levels, which is, in my opinion, imperative. My opinion might be a bit skewed. I have what I like to say is a volunteer program, and I do everything all the time. I'm stepping into the chair electoral for the renal dietitians dietetic practice group, which is part of the Academy of Nutrition Dietetics. I was actually on the planning committee for this particular meeting. So I and six other dietitians or so, planned the whole educational content for this meeting for the National Kidney Foundation over the past year, which was really fun. Honestly, it was my first time on the planning committee, and it was just really fun to kind of see how all of these sessions get planned, sort of the politics behind that, and to also just get to meet so many wonderful dietitians, and just really an honor, honestly, to be involved in planning such a large meeting because I've never done that before. So that was very cool. So anyway, that's the National Kidney Foundation, and so that is the one organization that really is geared more towards sort of that advocacy, education of all healthcare professionals. That's them. The other organization is the American Society of Nephrology, which is another amazing organization. This one is much more science-based and much more geared towards physicians or towards those nephrologists. I've only been to that meeting once before, but we'll actually be going this fall. It will be in San Diego in October, and I've actually been invited to speak about kidney stones, and I'm super, super stoked about that. But that meeting is, like I said, much more geared towards nephrologists. When you walk around that conference, at least in my experience, it was probably 95% actual doctors, which is important because doctors obviously need to learn too. And they have a much different, all healthcare professionals are obviously going to be learning about different aspects of kidney health. And so it's really important that both of these exist. But for me as a dietitian, it just has made a lot more sense to volunteer and be more involved with the National Kidney Foundation. But I also think it is so important that dietitians and social workers and pharmacists and nurses speak to not just ourselves, if that makes sense, right? So I do, you know, a ton of public speaking. That's been something that I've really enjoyed, sort of stepping away, being out on my own, and just being the kidney dietitian now and not working at the University of Chicago, is that I have a lot more time to go out and speak. In fact, I consider that part of my role as, you know, the founder and CEO, as I say, of the kidney dietitian, is to go out and educate other healthcare professionals about kidney stones, because I'm just one person, right? I as many people as I touch every day through my blog and social media content and this podcast, there is no way that I can help everyone with kidney stones out there and touch every single healthcare professional to help them learn about kidney stone nutrition. And so I consider it part of my mission with the kidney dietitian to go out and do as much speaking as possible. And I've really, really enjoyed that. And so I am thrilled to be speaking to a group of physicians in the fall about kidney stone nutrition, because I think if anyone needs to hear it, like, they probably need to hear it the most. And this is true whether I'm talking about kidney stones or plant-based diets for chronic kidney disease or managing hyperkalemia and avoiding our strict low potassium diets or whatever it is, right? It's just really important that all of us are on the same page, because I think so often I speak to groups of dietitians and they're on board, right? They're like, yes, Melanie, this sounds wonderful. Because dietitians are approaching nutrition and approaching healthcare very similarly. And oftentimes it's very different than how maybe a doctor is approaching nutrition. And so it's, I think, really, really important that we are all working together in an interdisciplinary fashion to learn about all this stuff. So I'm super stoked about that presentation and presentation coming up this October. So I digress. I get very passionate about talking about all this stuff, so sometimes I get a little bit off topic. So anyway, we've got those two organizations, right? The National Kidney Foundation and the American Society of Nephrology, both wonderful, ginormous organizations that sort of serve a slightly different purpose when it comes to helping educate the nephrology community, healthcare professionals, and also advocating for patients and that sort of thing, right? So as a reminder, since I did get a bit off topic, I was at the National Kidney Foundation meeting last week, had a wonderful time. It was really fun to be in California. I live in Chicago, and so don't get out to the West Coast nearly as often as I would like to. I love going out there. Some of my very best friends live out there, and so it was really, really fun to be out there and also just connect with so many dietitian friends. One very, very cool thing that I didn't really anticipate about sort of putting myself out there and doing this whole social media and blogging thing is that I've made a ton of really, really wonderful friends via Instagram. So it's really, really cool. And I, you know, feel like I've known some of these women for years and maybe have never even met them. If you don't know Michelle Krosmer at Plant Based Kidneys, that is her Instagram handle. I feel like I've known her, I have known her, right, for 3 or 4 years now, 4 years, gosh. But I've never actually met her in person. And she lives in LA, so she was in Long Beach, and I got to have dinner with her, which was so, so lovely. Through Instagram and various conferences, I've also become pretty close with Jen Hernandez. She is at Plant Powered Kidneys. I've also spent a ton of time with a dietitian named Lauren Bud Levy. She is at Happy Health Nutrition is her Instagram handle. I saw Kate Zalewski, who is your kidney dietitian. Kate actually lives about 4 tiny blocks from me here in Chicago. We randomly discovered that. She she posted this big skeleton that's outside of a bar a couple blocks from me, and I was like, wait a minute, Kate, you live like right in my neighborhood, right here in Chicago. So we have lunch sometimes, which is very, very nice. I saw Edith Yang. She is Healthy Mission Dietitian. Like, I could go on. Tons and tons of other wonderful dietitians that are doing work similar to me to help put good quality education content into the world. Everyone else focuses in kidney disease. So if you have kidney disease, In addition to kidney stones, certainly please check out their content because it's lots of dietitians doing really, really wonderful things. So if nothing else, these conferences are such a great way to connect with dietitians and have really, really engaging and inspiring conversations about the way that we are helping people and novel approaches to things and how to maybe dive into research in different ways. And like just endless, really inspiring, great conversation. So I had a great time. And the purpose, the reason that I wanted to really share my experience in Long Beach at the National Kidney Foundation meeting with you was because I was on the planning committee, as I said, and I pushed to get some kidney stone educational content on the program, and I did it. And I was so thrilled because it may come as a surprise, that typically in nephrology-focused meetings, there really isn't much about kidney stones. It really, really, the content and education sessions really, really focus on kidney disease, which is obviously very, very important. But unfortunately, kidney stones just aren't really there. I'm not really sure why. I don't know, if maybe people feel that people aren't interested in learning about it or don't realize how much there is to know about kidney stones. I think if I had to pick, I think that's really why a lot of these nephrology conferences are missing content around kidney stones is I think that people think that they just don't know what they don't know, right, when it comes to stone prevention. So anyway, I was super, super stoked that I got a whole kidney stone pre-conference session on the program for dietitians. And I even got two of my, I would consider them my mentors, like two women that I look up to most, certainly top five people that I look up to and have learned from in terms of kidney stone nutrition, to speak at that 4-hour pre-conference session about kidney stones for dietitians. And the best part about this pre-conference session was that the turnout was amazing. So for these pre-conference sessions, we don't get hundreds of people because you have to pay extra and you have to come in a day early. So the goal was kind of like 25 people, right? That would be good. There was 40 people at least. I swear that some snuck in at the end because it was literally standing room only in this session that I put together. Literally, they were like pulling in chairs and it was kind of awkward because there wasn't places for people to sit. It was so exciting, guys. Like, these dietitians were so excited to learn about kidney stones. They were willing to fly in a whole day early. They were willing to take off a whole nother day off of work, pay a bit extra, which is always in addition to what's always a very expensive week at a conference, paying for the registration and hotel and eating and all that stuff. So I was like flying high. I still am. Yeah, I'm just so excited to see how much interest there was in learning about kidney stones. Like, people came up to me afterwards and said this was the most amazing session they've ever been to at a conference ever. I can't say if that's true. That is a really big statement, but it was so wonderful to see so many dietitians there at all, and also so many dietitians so engaged, tons of really great questions and conversation after all of the sessions during that half day course. It was so exciting. So I just had to share that I think, so my thoughts are, to answer the question of this podcast, kind of where is the state of kidney stone nutrition nationwide? I think unfortunately it's quite low. I know that dietitians are not taught about kidney stones during their education. It's not like a required thing that we have to learn about. All dietitians have to have some experience working with diabetes and kidney disease and hypertension and cancer and GI stuff and tube feeds, right? There's tons and tons and tons of different disease states that we have to learn about, but kidney stones is not on there. Honestly, chronic kidney disease, I don't think, I should check on this, but I don't think that's even on there in terms of pre-dialysis. Certainly, we have to be exposed to kidney nutrition in some way, but it could just be dialysis. And we know that nutrition for dialysis is very, very, very different than someone with chronic kidney disease who is not on dialysis or who has not had a kidney transplant yet. So dietitians just don't really know. And even those of us that work in nephrology, who work in kidney nutrition, the vast majority of us, first of all, work in dialysis. There are more and more and more dietitians working in the CKD space, which is super exciting. But even that doesn't necessarily mean that you know much about kidney stones, just because, again, it's so, so specialized, and we're just not really exposed to it. But I do think that there is a movement, or at least an interest. I might be biased because this is what I do, is I educate people about kidney stone nutrition. But I really do think, just because that pre-con was so well attended and people were so excited about it, and just like even a lot of people stopped me at the conference and said they wish they could have come but couldn't, the day off, whatever. Like, I just think that there is kind of a growing interest in learning more about kidney stone prevention, which is so exciting, because you know that I do what I do because I feel passionately that every single person who has had even one kidney stone, right? One kidney stone is too many. Kidney stones aren't supposed to be forming. There are things that we can do to prevent it. And it's just super, super exciting that I think that there is growing interest and at least understanding of what nutrition can do to prevent kidney stones, at least within the dietitian community. So like I said, that session was for dietitians. So there actually were a couple physicians, doctors that attended, which is super exciting. I don't interact with doctors nearly as much as I wish that I would. Like I said, I need to figure out ways and avenues to speak in front of physicians, because I think that arguably is maybe even more important than dietitians, because the doctors are the ones that need to refer patients to see us to help prevent stones. But so I don't know if there's the same interest in the physician groups, but I think at least within dietitians, I think we are really, really understanding that nutrition plays a huge role and that we can really, really help change people's lives by preventing kidney stones, by stopping them from these cycles of getting stone after stone after stone and having surgery after surgery after surgery. There are things that we can do to prevent stones. So thrilled. I also have to give a shout out to those two people that I mentioned that spoke at the pre-conference session that I planned. So the first one is Dr. Anna Zisman. She's actually been on this podcast twice before. So in some of the earlier episodes, if you're interested, go check it out. She is a nephrologist that I worked with at the University of Chicago and is just amazing. She is one of those people that you think, man, I'm never going to be as smart as she is, right? She is just very, very good at her job, and she is currently the director of the Kidney Stone Program at the University of Chicago, and so is really one of the top worldwide, honestly, kidney stone doctors, and has learned from some of the all-time biggest names when it comes to kidney stone prevention, Dr. Fred Koh at the University of Chicago. And so she really is the reason that I love kidney stones so much. She, like I said, I worked with her at the University of Chicago, and she just kind of really sparked this interest in stones and sort of took an interest in me, honestly, and in teaching me, and helped also saw me as an important part of the medical team that showed me really how a stone clinic should work in terms of a dietitian-physician relationship. So anyway, not to get too hunky-dory, but Dr. Anna Zisman is wonderful, and she really is the reason that I love kidney stones so much. So it was an honor to have her speak there. And the other person that spoke was Dr. Christina Peniston. She is a scientist. She is a PhD RD, so a dietitian who also has her PhD. And she works at the University of Wisconsin. So most of her time is spent in research, kidney stone research, the vast majority. And she also sees patients in the stone clinic there in Wisconsin. And she is like the dietitian when it comes to kidney stones. She, because of her research role and her PhD, she is very, very often the only dietitian in the room in a whole big group of doctors. I'm really advocating for dietitians to be a part of kidney stone care. And which is a really big deal, because oftentimes, like I said, our education, not only is the medical system unfortunately very siloed, right? Like, doctors don't necessarily talk to each other, the dietitians don't necessarily talk to the doctors, the social workers, right? But our education also tends to be very siloed. So the fact that she is out there educating lots of doctors all the time is really, really important, and a really wonderful thing that she does. And she, again, is one of those people you're like, man, she is so smart, and I have learned so much from her. She's helped me publish some papers, and she's just truly my kidney stone dietitian mentor. So it was so amazing to have both of these women in the room who have influenced my career and helped me learn so much and have really honestly helped me get to where I am today. So yeah, that's really what I wanted to share. I hope that's interesting. I think I'm just so excited after spending such a wonderful week in Long Beach, meeting so many people and having so many inspiring conversations about different things that we can do, different ways that we can show that dietitians do matter for both kidney stones and chronic kidney disease, meeting with different brands and pharmaceutical companies and ways that I can utilize their resources to help help me further educate more and more people. Lots of exciting things, I hope, for the kidney dietitian and for the kidney stone nephrology community as a whole. So with that, I will close this episode of the Eat Away Kidney Stones podcast. Thank you so much for listening. If you enjoyed this episode, please let me know. Please leave a review. And if you didn't, let me know too. It's always good to hear what types of episodes people enjoy and don't enjoy. So with that, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope that I see you next week on the Eat Away Kidney Stones podcast. Thank you for listening to today's episode. For more help with kidney stones, check out my website, www.thekidneydietitian.org. For more personalized help from me, check out my online course, Kidney Stone Nutrition School. VIP enrollment includes help directly from me. I can't wait to see you there and help you prevent kidney stones. Have a great day.